Welcome everyone, I hope you had a nice break. And I'm going to talk about my research on exploiting thin-ply materials to establish controlled failure in carbon composites. So first of all, I will give you a brief introduction and background to my PhD. Then I will show you what's the outline about and talk about the specific loading case that I've been working on, and then conclude my presentation. So as we all know, composite materials play a significant role in the development of today's advanced engineering structures. So in key industries such as aerospace, automotive, and civil engineering, it is in crucial importance to be able to determine their strength the most accurate way possible. It is also very important to take material variability into account, and as recommended by aeronautical standards, and to establish behavior in realistic operation conditions, especially under multi-axial loadings. So the key goal would be to reduce the cost, the product lead time, and ensure safe operation in service, especially in industry. As we know, composite failure is very complex. There are many different modes, the sequence they occur, how they interact with each other, and one of the biggest research studies, the Worldwide Failure Exercises, concluded that currently exists no universally accepted criterion. And also we have a very low confidence in the failure prediction. As you can see on this graph, the different damage mechanisms and in function of the confidence levels, these are quite low, especially for delamination. It is very difficult to obtain reliable experimental data, and even in very simple unidirectional tensile tests, the stress concentrations could lead to premature failure, a knockdown in strength, and also lowered measure strain to failure values. So the main objective of my PhD is to exploit these thin composites to establish controlled failure for two reasons. One, investigate the effect of different stress components on the fibre direction failure strain, and to provide visual indication of damage. So based on that, I've been using thin-ply materials mainly to isolate some failure mechanisms, because thin-plies, they are shown to be suppressing damage mechanisms such as delamination and matrix cracking. And as I've said before, one of the projects is to purpose design to achieve a desired failure mode, such as my project was on unidirectional hybrid composite overload sensors, which you can see here, specific failure mode. And the other one is to control the failure mechanism by generating multi-axial stress states in the unidirectional layers by using novel test methods. So the four different loading cases that I've been working on, two of them which have been completed to date and two of them which I'm currently working on now. And now I will talk about one of them, which is specifically the longitudinal tension and transverse compression case, where we have developed a novel tensile test configuration where you have thin-ply UD carbon epoxy laminates in the center, embedded in angle-ply thin-ply blocks of the same material, and the transverse compression is put on the central UD layers by the scissoring deformation of the angle-ply blocks. So in this summary table, you will see the measured longitudinal and transverse strains to failure and the calculated stresses for all configurations, including the baseline. So what I would like to outline is that in a uniaxial test, we wouldn't have transverse stresses arising on a laminate level. However, in this case, there are transverse stresses arising in the central UDs because of the Poisson contraction of the angle plies. And these stresses can be calculated from the measured strains and also the material properties. So we can see very high transverse strains. And if you plot these measured transverse strains in function of the longitudinal fiber failure strain, we can see that there is a negligible effect of high transverse stresses on the failure strain. And with this, I would like to conclude this kind of work package where we can develop the novel test configuration incorporating a thin-ply composite laminate under biaxial stresses with very high indirectly applied transverse compressive strain and low variability. We have achieved equivalent to about 145 megapascal of stress, assuming linear responses. For all configurations, we observed a fiber failure mode, and the overall transverse strains were higher than in a typical multidirectional laminate, exceeding the 90 fiber direction compressive strain to failure. So all in all, I can say that tensile failure is negligibly affected by the transverse compressive stresses. In my future work, in my PhD, I am looking at completing the tension and tension and the compression tension quadrants. Thank you for your attention, and I would like to acknowledge Onera, the French Aerospace Lab, for the collaborative project we have together.